all across the Volunteer State, it's time to go Inside the Orange. Inside the Orange, a look at the University of Tennessee sports scene. Brought to you each week by First Tennessee, home to Big Orange Banking. First Tennessee, the official bank of the Vols. By Dish, proud to be an official sponsor of the Big Orange. Catch the Vols and Lady Vols on Dish. By Food City, the official tailgating headquarters of Vol fans everywhere. Food City, value every day. And by your local Ford dealer. Find fuel-efficient vehicles and great offers at shopfordnow.com. Go further. Now, the Vol Network takes you Inside the Orange.
Hello and welcome to Inside the Orange. I'm your host, Evan Ellis. Inside the Orange is an eight-week journey into the world of sports in the springtime at the University of Tennessee, giving you the sights and sounds of Vol and Lady Vol athletics on and off the field. On this week's show, we'll go NASCAR racing at Bristol Motor Speedway with head football coach Butch Jones. We'll go to Nashville with the men's basketball team and get ready for the NCAA Women's Basketball Tournament with the Lady Vols. All that and more next as we head Inside the Orange. This season's Southeastern Conference Men's Basketball Tournament invaded the Music City, and the fifth-seeded Vols took on Mississippi State in their first game at Bridgestone Arena. Let's go behind the scenes with Coach Martin's team as they prepare to play the Bulldogs.
But the passion is for us, man. High energy, man. So most of them, you gotta have a passion, man. Anybody can beat you in this venue. So as you walk out, as you stretch, anything can happen. We gotta play as hard as we can play. 10 possessions down, if I don't get a shot and we win it, I'm good. Most important thing, I'm gonna play hard, I'm gonna play deep, and I'm gonna do my job. Somebody roll to find a way to keep it rolling. Take care of the ball, push and transition. You gotta run, guys. You gotta get out and transition. It's not a bad pass, not a wild pass. Not just run to be running, not force some shot. You run and score. If you don't have it, run the offense, pound the ball inside. But it's how Tennessee plays the game, guys. The most important thing, we're not playing all, we gotta fight. That's work hard, you press, and gotta win the NCAA, get in the tournament. We're playing a basketball game. We're trying everything I thought to win the basketball game against Mississippi State. And we move to whatever's presented to us. The most important thing is to go, guys. Anything can happen. Everything we've worked on is a new season. Because you're fighting for something greater than what they are. They have to be. Compete as a young team, they'll be good in the future. So everything bonus. We don't have nothing to lose, guys. The coach said, we got to lose. They're supposed to be. All their mentality. You always got something to lose, unless that's your mentality. You're a dead man walking. Go out and battle as hard as you can battle. You don't let us down. Let's go.
Okay. We didn't do it all right.
Set to go at the Bridgestone Arena. Tennessee out, the higher-seeded team, fifth seed in the tournament, wearing the home white with orange numerals. The Bulldogs come out in the maroon and white. Joe Lindsay to toss it up in between Gavin Ware and Jarnell Stokes, wherever you're listening. And Big Orange Country, glad to have you with us today in the opening tap, won by the Bulldogs. Back to McCray. He's going to pull up, fire three. Good.
Money.
McCray drives the other way, in the lane, puts it off the glass. Count. Good. It's going to count. Here's Trey Golden, drives to the basket, puts it up and in. Count the basket and a foul. Golden drives, kicks it off to Richardson, back up front McBee. Fakes, pulls up, fires and hits. That's a three. Stokes makes a move on Ware, turns, half hook in front. Good. Here's Golden, drives, puts it off the glass and scores. An And then it's re-stolen by Armani Moore. Gives it to Stokes, and he slams.
Great play by Armani.
6:08 to go as McGray throws a pass inside Kenny Hall. Fakes, lays it up, and slams it. Porkert, he lost it, and Stokes comes up with it. Outlet pass McBee, ahead of the pack. Layup, no good, but followed up with a slam by Quinton Chivas. Golden, top of the key, drives hard, pulls up, 10-foot floater, good. Flips it back to Richardson, top of the circle. Down low, Stokes turns, lays it up with the left hand, good, against Ware. Golden drives into traffic, throws up a runner that's going to bounce in.
Got to penetrate, good play by Trey.
Here's McCray, pulls up, alley-oop. Slam by Armani Moore.
That was a sweet play.
McCray, who hadn't scored this half, drives, puts it up, and in off the glass, counted, and he's fouled.
Big shot right there.
Mississippi State in front court, and stealing the ball is McCray at midcourt, right from Sword, and he slams with a 360 spin. How about that one?
That's got the crowd, made everybody happy.
Loudest crowd noise we've had all day. Mississippi State inbounds it. Sword's going to dribble to midcourt. He won't take another shot. This game is going to end, and the Tennessee Volunteers win their first game in Nashville at the SEC Tournament. Final score, Tennessee 69 and Mississippi State 53.
Tennessee's victory over Mississippi State was Coach Martin's first in the SEC Tournament. The win also marked his 100th career victory as a head coach. We're going NASCAR racing. We return on Inside the Orange. Nestled in the quiet northeast Tennessee city of Bristol is Thunder Valley, the Bristol Motor Speedway. And at the Food City 500, Tennessee head football coach Butch Jones had the opportunity to say the most famous words in motorsports.
You can fall right here. That would not be good. Make sure y'all don't fall. You come to Bristol, and obviously everyone understands what this great race is all about. How you doing?
How are you?
Nice to see you. Good morning. First race. This is amazing.
I know. I read where you were kind of excited about being here.
I'm fired up. Coming here, and again, it's the magnitude of Tennessee football. And you see everyone dressed in orange and excited for Tennessee football along with NASCAR.
No ball!
Well, look who I found here in the garage, Butch Jones, the U of Tennessee head football coach, the Grand Marshal. Well, how are you feeling being here? What are you absorbing so far?
Oh, I'm officially a big fan, and I will be back. Words can't describe it. And so I've been like a little kid all day.
Thank you.
Thank you. Danica. Butch Jones.
Nice to meet you. Mark is going to run my sister
too. Well, I brought something for your sister.
Oh, well,
I brought some gifts for you. So this is a game-worn jersey.
Look at that. She gets to pretend like real jersey.
That's
I
right.
don't even have a real jersey.
We'll have to get you one.
Oh, cool. Thank you.
I know you got a busy day, so thank you for
You're
your
welcome.
Time.
You're welcome. Very, very nice.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Okay.
I'm sure we'll be out. Oh, you always say thank you. Of course, Mark always says thank you.
How are you?
Good to see you.
Nice to meet you. I appreciate you coming by and saying hello.
Oh, hey, I loved it. When I heard you were here, I wanted to get a chance to say hello.
How are you doing?
Did the races?
First one ever. I'm hooked already.
What you would get on this deal, it's exactly like football. I'm amazed. Every time somebody walks around the corner, they go, you're not going to believe this. And I said, yes, I will. I've already been through this.
Okay,
man.
Thank you. Good luck.
Yeah, I bleed orange in wintertime, I'll tell
you. Boy, if ever you want to come, please, you're welcome.
I'm going to try. I always try. My son went to school over there.
Okay.
I'm a dad to a little good team family. I will definitely try to come back
here. Please.
I'd love to.
I would love to have you be my guest.
I would be honored, sir. Thank
okay.
you, family. Good to see
Thank
you.
Thank you. Nice
I'm
to
so
meet you.
I'm so glad I got to meet you.
We have a lot of momentum right now, and it's, you know, the most storied football program in all of college football, the University of Tennessee, and so we're on the rise as we're talking about. from the orange and white checkerboards at the University of Tennessee to the black and white checkered flag at Bristol. Drivers, start your engines!
That command got the fans and the drivers fired up for both NASCAR and Tennessee football. Speaking of football, we'll talk spring practice on Rocky Top when we come back on Inside the Orange. We know that Butch Jones was excited for the NASCAR race, but back on the football field, spring practice is in high gear. Sarah Mitchell has a report from Haslam Field where the Vols are working hard.
Hey Tennessee fans, welcome to Vol Report number 5. We're back in the indoor facility due to rain here in Knoxville, but that's no factor in the energy level from Coach Jones and Team 117.
Well, I thought today probably our best overall practice of the spring, obviously very early, but I really liked the mental effort, the mental intensity, the focus, you know, of our team. And I was really waiting to see how we would respond on a Tuesday after a long Saturday practice. Still a lot of work to do, but for the first time I could see some things coming together in terms of swarming to the football. You know, I liked the overall physicality of practice. A long way to go, but I think the big thing as we continue to progress is focusing on what it takes to play winning football.
Coach Jones is expecting his players to become more consistent and to challenge each other in upcoming practices.
Well, I think each individual is different. You know, we have some individuals right now that have great consistency in their performance and they're separating themselves. You know, we have some individuals who are still working on that consistency factor. And so, you know, the big thing I think we have to do is every person has to challenge themselves and they got to challenge each other to be better football players and to be a better football team every time we step on the football field or in the weight room.
With room for improvement, senior Byron Moore looks forward to the increased competition amongst the team.
Still got a long ways to go, but everybody got the right attitude. Everybody's wanting to be coached. They want to come out here and learn each day. So everybody's got to put in a great effort. So we just got to keep sawing at the wood, keep progressing as we go.
Every rep counts. That's what he preaches to us. Every rep counts, from one-on-ones, to pass rush, to team. Everything counts. And at the end of the day, whoever wins, you know, we get to keep doing the journey, so it's making us take a lot of pride in who's winning those each reps, because we want to be the ones that, you know, keep the orange jerseys.
Senior Jawan James is encouraged by Coach Jones' pace and style of play.
Today, you know, I was talking to Zach going on the field. Today was the first day we really caught our breath, you know, as an offensive line with the tempo of practice. You know, so today felt good. I feel like I'm getting back in, you know, the playing shape. We haven't put pads on since November. And, I mean, Coach Jones doing a good job, you know, making practice, you know, competitive, you know, making live feeds and stuff like that. So practice is fun. And, I mean, it is going well right now.
Thanks for joining me for this Vol Report right here on UTSports.com. Don't miss Thursday's practice as the Vols continue to improve on speed and strength in preparation for the Dish Network Orange and White Spring Game on April 20th. I'm your host, Sarah Mitchell, and I'll see you next time.
Tennessee has allowed just 15 practices during spring drills, and the 15th and final practice is the Dish Orange and White Game at Neyland Stadium on April 20th. We'll talk Lady Vol basketball when we return on Inside the Orange. It's NCAA Women's Basketball Tournament time again for the Lady Vols, and Holly Warlick's first team learned their seeding at the East Club at Neyland Stadium.
Thank you. two seed will feature Tennessee.
I'm really proud of them. I think they deserve a two seed.
I mean, everyone knows and respects Baylor, and we all know they're a great team, but we also believe in who we are and what we can do, and they call it March Madness, you know, for a reason. You never know what's going to happen.
I think that's the biggest thing coming down the stretch is, you know, just using your mind, because at the end of the day, we're all talented players, but the best team's going to get it done here and right here.
Well, that wraps this week's show. I'm Evan Ellis, and I'll see you again next week when we go Inside the Orange.
From the Huster Broadcast Center, this has been a presentation of the Vol Network, produced by IMG, the world's premier sports, entertainment, and media company.